Hi guys, Brown here, and welcome back to my F1 2019 career mode. Here today for another messy episode, I'm sorry. But what I have done is I've found the highlights for Russia, and so they're going to be playing back in the background. In this episode we're going to be doing America, you may have guessed that from the thumbnail, but Mexico, I had issues as well. But that was a pretty boring race anyway, so I have highlights for them both. So now I'm just gonna talk you through what happened in each race. So Russia, we started on pole, we had a good start, and then we didn't really go anywhere. We had a very personal battle with Pierre Gasly that you can see on screen now, that lasted a few laps. Sergio Perez coming up through the field and eventually leading the race at one point after we overtook myself and Pierre Gasly. But you can see the battle with Gasly, there was no way I was letting him pass. You got to remember, at this point in time we had already come together in Italy and then come together in Singapore, so the next round, obviously being Russia, it all got a bit personal, and there was no way I was going to wave him through, even if he is just my teammate. And you can see it's still going here, even if he tries pushing us off the track, that's still not going to happen. And we get the job done there around the outside, and here it is. Those of you that didn't believe me in the last episode, in Japan, there it is, the safety car. It was in the Russia race, I told you it was. And then after that, the safety car came up, we pitted, and then it was actually Daniel Ricciardo that brought it out. And then we just battling with the Mercedes, and then we just pulled away. And that was pretty much the race. And we went on to win by a fairly comfortable margin from Valtteri Bottas, I believe it was. Now into Mexico, we had an awful qualifying. We started all the way down in 17th, and then I had to take a penalty for a new combustion engine, so that put us all the way down in last place. But we had an absolutely mega start. By the end of lap one, I was already up into P10. As you can see, there was a mighty start round the outside of several cars, and obviously, like I said, just we got up into 10th place. But then after that, I was just really struggling to find my rhythm, find my pace. I was really struggling at the stadium section, and with my braking point into that tight left hander, and that pretty much was the race. It was fairly boring, to be honest. It was one of those races when you're on, let's say, 17, 18, and then you sort of just sat there wishing the laps along. It was very boring. We're actually a whole pit stop behind those in front, and you can see here, this is a battle with Lucas Weber. We just did the one stop from the mediums onto the hards, and to be honest, the mediums didn't have any pace whatsoever. The hards weren't too bad, but of course they were always going to degrade. And then we just had a battle here with Devon Butler. We went miles off the track there. He actually clipped the curb and went, and that unsettled his car, and we actually re-overtook him there. And then one lap later, the same thing, pretty much copy and paste, but this time we're going to go all the way around the outside. There's contact at the inside, and then we're still on the outside to stay ahead. And then that was pretty much it, and that was kind of the roundup of the last two rounds. So now you're up to date, and we can get into qualifying for America. And I love this track, I love America. This is towards the end of our first run, and it puts us into P2, and we actually get through fairly comfortably in 10th place. In 10th place, you can see there who is out into Q2 towards the end of our first run, and we go P7. And there is actually a rain forecast for Sunday, so I was just using the soft tires. There was really no point trying to go for it on the mediums with the fact it is supposed to be raining at the start of the race. But we're into Q2, only just a P10, and then this is our first run in Q3 around the final corner, and that is going to put us P10. It was an awful lap, so we're going to continue on. We're going to go again. This is at the end of the session. Now you can see we've gone purple in sector 1. We're up in sector 2. Now into this second to last corner. Fairly comfortably through there. And it's really hard to spot that braking point for the final corner, especially with the sun glaring down on us. But we crossed the line. And that is going to be P5. Jeff, not really happy with that. Pete Gasly, our teammate, out qualifying us. Let's get into this race.
What fantastic enthusiasm we have for Formula One here in the United States of America. And it's an enthusiasm born from generations of memorable Grand Prix racing. Bruce McLaren took his maiden victory at Sebring way back in 1959, and John Watson's 1983 victory at Long Beach, well, that still holds the record for the lowest ever starting position for a race winner. We have 10 turns to the left and 10 to the right here at the fantastic Circuit of the Americas. Overtaking opportunities into turns 1 and 12 at this anti-clockwise 3.6-mile track. But we may well see cars struggle to slow down there today as the wet weather does interfere with the low-speed grip. Anthony Davidson, a very warm welcome to you as you join me in the commentary box for today's event. Can we begin by having a chat about Charles Leclerc? There's a real chance they could win the title today. So how do you think they'll handle the pressure?
I think as long as they keep their mind on the task and not its historical significance, they'll be just fine. This is a race just like any other. You do the best you can and accept that sometimes things are going to happen outside of your control. If they can approach today with that attitude, the pressure shouldn't be a problem.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Young superstar Max Verstappen starts from pole position, with Sebastian Vettel starting alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Brown, Russell, Nico Hülkenberg, and Norris, Weber, Giovinazzi, Hamilton. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. And Daniel Ricciardo, Gasly, Butler, Sergio Perez, and Bottas. Leclerc, Magnussen, Alexander Albon, and Roman Grosjean. Kubica and Lance Stroll brings the grid to a close. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
So the rain is going to stop by the end, but when wherever it does, we'll have to wait and see. We're going to put a lot of fuel in the car because the fuel seems to go down very quickly in these wet races. And let's see what we can do as the fire for lights come on here. It's lights out and away we go. Everyone literally tiptoeing off the line. We get up into third after I think there was penalties. And we're going to go for the lunge down the inside. And we're going to take the lead into turn one of the American Grand Prix. And now we're going to have to head and see what we can do. And I'm gonna be absolutely honest here, you can see how all over the place I was. I literally couldn't see the track, and that's why in just a second, you can see here, we go straight on and lose out to both Max Verstappen and Sebastian Vettel. We've just about managed to stay ahead of Lando Norris in his McLaren, but we're back down into third. And that goodish start that we got putting us into the lead, gone in a couple of corners, and now we seriously have to get our head down, try not to make mistakes. These are very, very tricky conditions, and let's just see what we can do. As skipping on now all the way to lap 7. Literally nothing happened. Verstappen and Vettel took off and I just couldn't stick with them, but I had enough pace to stay it just in front of those behind me, and that was pretty much it for those first 6 laps. We're going to go on to now the inters. The track drying fairly quickly, the rain kind of stop him fairly quickly as well. So let's just see what we can do in the second stint. Being now can possibly start to push a little bit more on lap 8, not only 20 laps to go. We've been beaten out by a racing point of Lance Stroll that hasn't pitted, and as we skip on literally the other end of the S section, we've caught the back of Lance Stroll. That's how much the track has dried up from the comparison from the wets to the full wets to the intermediate tyres. But Lance Stroll not giving up. Of course, that racing point does have good straight line speed, but it is the second slowest car on the grid. If you look at the R&D, and we're going to have to hold the line all the way around the outside there, and we do fairly comfortably. And now this is actually helping us out, that Lando Norris cannot, I think it's actually Hülkenberg, cannot get past Stroll. Eventually Stroll pitted, but that gave us a little bit of breathing space to deal with. And this is Verstappen and Sebastian Vettel going wheel to wheel, and there they are side by side. Vettel trying to get the job done now to the outside. He had a little look to the inside, and now Verstappen's just going to hang him out to dry. And now through the long right-hander, just like Max Verstappen did to Kimi Raikkonen all the way around the outside, he defends Sebastian Vettel for now. Going into the final corner then, Sebastian Vettel I don't think would have given up, but I don't think it's quite close enough. As skipping onto lap 13, the track is dry enough for the dry tyres in this race. It's lap 14, so we're just under the half, we are at the halfway mark, and they are going to go on to the set of the soft tyres is Max Verstappen and Sebastian Vettel. But when we come in, I was thinking about the long term, let's see if we can go to the end. So I'm going to put on the set of the medium compound tyre, the yellow sidewall, and then just try and go to the end. I thought those on the soft, you can't go that far, and I don't think I actually had a fresh set of softs to actually put on in the first place. So the mediums are going to have to do, and plus we can get to the end on them, but just struggling for pacing. See here, make a massive mistake, but we instantly gain it back because I went wide, you can see here, and then Lewis Hamilton just decides to brake when he gets past us, and then hangs us back the position. A very, very odd incident that. You can see it from Hamilton's point of view, you'll see he'll just tap on the brakes, turn something down, and just lets us back through. So he thought about taking that position off of us, that third place, but then he thought better of it. But here he comes, lap 15, two laps later comes Lewis Hamilton round the outside. He's going to try and to turn one on us. We force him wide like he did to Rosberg some years ago, and we stay ahead of the six-time champion. Now it is literally between three drivers that can still win the championship. Hamilton's one of them. Here comes Lando Norris down the inside. He tries on it. He tried to get past us, and his left defending Lewis Hamilton. He's lost out to Lewis Hamilton. We've gone wide. Hamilton's on our outside now. It's absolutely gone mental. We defend Hamilton to the inside at a very tight corner. And now round the long right-hander, we can now try to build a gap, but that's not going to happen. Skipping on to lap 16, and Lewis Hamilton's back passes, and now we're left turning Lando Norris, but we're not done there. We're going to go for the lunge down the inside. We've lost out, and now back down the inside again. There's slight contact again, and Hamilton's lost out to Lando Norris there, and now maybe to George Russell as well in the Williams. And this is the battle for the lead. One lap later, Max Verstappen re-overtakes Sebastian Vettel for the lead of the American Grand Prix. We're still not done with Lando Norris though. Lewis Hamilton's fallen way back. I think there was contact with him, and he actually lost a part of his front wing, so he's just fallen back, and you can see just behind Lando Norris he is. we defend Lando Norris. Just about, and now Hamilton's having a look at Lando Norris. And now Hamilton's having a look at us. As here he comes again. Down the inside tries Lewis Hamilton, and he does overtake us there. Nothing I could really do except try to go for the lunge back down the inside. That's not going to work. But Lewis Hamilton has got the position off of us. But this corner coming up is very wide, and we're going to go down the inside. And we're going to re-overtake. And there was a bit of contact there as well from Lewis Hamilton's front wing. And skipping on to lap 24. Robert Kubica retired from this Grand Prix. He pulls off to the track, is slowed right down, going on to lap 25. And the safety car has been deployed. And this time we can actually see it. Wow. We've had 37 episodes, not a single safety car. And on the 38th episode, we finally have a safety car, and that's going to help us out because everyone pitted literally two laps before the safety car came out. So now we can go on to the soft tyre. It was a worn set, but it was only going to be from quali, which I'd literally done one lap on, so they literally had 6% wear, so it was fine. We're going to come out in P3, retain our third place, and now we're sitting very pretty from when the safety car goes in. It will only be two or three laps after the safety car comes in to actually get ahead in this race. So you can see here everyone following the safety car on lap 26. And actually, something that I found, I'm not complaining, this gonna sound like I'm complaining, but it's really hard to kind of manage your pace behind the safety car. The safety car seems very slow this year. I just remember on F1 2018, you could kind of get comfortable, put your foot in a nice position, and that was it. You could stay there unless someone brake checked you. But as we come towards the end of lap 26, the safety car is going to come in. You can see there, the safety car ghosted, and now it's up to Sebastian Vettel to guide us round, deciding when to go. I'm just right on the back of Max Verstappen, because we can maybe get the win, but we can at least get second place in this race if we get the best launch we can off this restart. Sebastian Vettel though not going till very late. The safety AI most of the time don't really wait, they normally go at the actual line, and off he goes. Sebastian Vettel restarts this Grand Prix. Then it will cross the line to start lap 27, so there's two to go, and we're not quite close enough to go for a lunge on Max Verstappen, and I did think about it. I kind of pulled out in the end though, because we were that little bit too far back. And now heading through the S section for the penultimate time, and now here comes Lando Norris. He isn't done with us yet. We couldn't go forward, we had to go backwards. Unfortunately, we defend Lando Norris on the final lap of this American Grand Prix. Heading round the final corner though, it's victory for Sebastian Vettel. His first win since, I don't even know, Belgium, I think. It's going to be Max Verstappen second, we're going to come home third, Lando Norris fourth, Nico Hülkenberg fifth. A great result from the McLaren boys. And now it is just three drivers in the standings. We're just 17 points behind Charles Leclerc going into the penultimate round, and it's between Charles, me and Lewis Hamilton who can win this 2020 title. There's still two to go. Mathematically, Hamilton can win the title, but he's 47 points behind Charles Leclerc, so it's pretty much impossible, but it is still technically possible. The chance of it actually happening, who knows? But we'll have to wait and see when we go to Brazil for the penultimate round of this season. What a season it's been. I know the last couple of races have been a bit messy, but I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have this season. If you have, don't forget to like. If you're new around here, don't forget to subscribe if you like this kind of content, and I will see you in Brazil. Goodbye.